गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स,
डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ द एलिमेंट्स। ओके, इफ यू सी द मॉडर्न पीरियडिक टेबल, देन इन द मॉडर्न पीरियडिक टेबल टोटल 118 एलिमेंट्स आर प्रेजेंट, इन विच 94 एलिमेंट्स आर द नेचुरल एंड 24 आर द आर्टिफिशियल, दैट इज मैन मेड। ओके, एंड इन द मॉडर्न पीरियडिक टेबल दीज एलिमेंट्स आर क्लासिफाइड इन द फॉर्म ऑफ means on the basis of their nature they classified into the metals, non-metals, metalloids and noble gases. See, metals are the elements which have tendency to lose the electron, non-metals which have tendency to gain the electron, once again metals which have tendency to lose the electron. Okay, how it will lose the electron, beta? Due to its electronic configuration. Suppose sodium has atomic number 11, so this sodium 281, this is only one electron in outermost shell, this is K shell, L shell, M shell. And if we will discuss about the octet rule, then according to octet rule the system which have 8 electron in outermost shell are more stable, that is complete octet, except lighter element. Once again I am going to tell about the octet rule. According to the octet rule, the system is what? Metals, that is elements or ion or molecule. The system which have complete doublet means two electron, this is only for the lighter elements, complete doublet and octet, except lighter, all will exist in the light octet form, means 8 electron in their outermost shell. So according to octet rule, the system which have complete doublet or octet are more stable. So if we will discuss about the sodium, then 281, only one electron in outermost shell, but here inner shell have 8 electrons, so it will try to gain the complete octet to become stable. That is why this sodium will lose the electron. So if the system are losing the electron, then they are gaining the positive charge. One electron it will lose, so it will gain one positive charge. Now what will remain? 2, 8, complete octet, this is more stable. It is more stable. And what about it? Less stable. Okay, my dear. Now suppose once again, here sodium, suppose you have the potassium or lithium which have atomic number 3, this is 2, 1, incomplete doublet means two electrons should be in the outermost shell because this is the lighter element, so it will try to lose the electron. So Li plus, now two electron, this is complete doublet, it is stable. So all the metals have tendency to lose the electron, either one electron, two electron, three electrons, whatever it is. It is on the basis of their valence electron. So metals, once again, simple definition of the metal, that metals are the elements which have tendency to lose the electron, whereas non-metals which have tendency to gain the electron. Non-metals are the elements which have tendency to gain the electron. For example, suppose fluorine. Fluorine atomic number 9, this is 2, 7. To complete their octet, it needs one more electron. See, 8 electrons should be there, na? But here only 7 electrons. So it will try to gain one electron. So from any system, if it will gain the electron, then it become minus. Because the system which will lose the electron will gain the positive charge. Which will gain the electron will gain the negative charge. So what happened? If it will gain one electron, then it 7 become 8. So this is 2, 8, complete octet, more stable. It is more stable. Understood, my dear? Suppose oxygen have atomic number 8. This is 2, 6. So incomplete octet, it will try to gain two electron to gain the complete octet. So it become, this is 2, 8, more stable. More stable. Okay, now please come on the metalloids. Metalloids are the elements which have tendency to sorry, lose and gain both electron means which are the properties of the both metals and non-metals. Okay, my dear, which are the property of both metals and non-metals? Metal has tendency to lose the electron, so non-metal will gain the electron. Metallates, if we will discuss about the metallates, then you can tell that this is boron and silicon, germanium, these all will come under the metallates. Okay, metals are good conductor for heat and electricity. Non-metals are bad conductor of heat and electricity. Metallates have the conductivity property in between the metals and non-metals. Noble gases are more stable because they have the complete octet. That is why they are said to be the inert gases. For example, suppose helium, helium atomic number 2, this is 2 electron. Complete doublet. Similarly, neon atomic number 10, this is 2, 8, complete octet, more stable. Argon atomic number 18, this is 2, 8, 8, more stable. So these all have the complete doublet for helium and complete octet for another member of the noble gases. That is why they are more stable. They are most stable. They not participated in the chemical reaction. That is why they are said to be the inert gases. These all are present in the group 18. In the model periodic table, in group 18 they are present. Okay, my dear. So this is the information about the metals, non-metals, metallates and noble gases. Please see the book and do the revision. Thank you. God bless you. Have a nice day.